Welcome to Intro Psychology. I'm Lauren.
I'm Susan.
And I'm Greg.
We're your instructors for this course. We're going to take you on your journey through psychology. We'll go over different areas of psychology and how different psychologists examine and explain thought and behavior.
We are all very different. We like different things, we think differently, we even react differently.
So for instance,
I have something here that might create different reactions than people.
Ooh.
My pet snake, Tickles. I've come to really enjoy him. He's a nice snake.
I wouldn't mind holding Tickles or touching him, but I certainly wouldn't want him as a pet. Lauren?
No, I don't do snakes.
You don't do snakes?
No, I don't do snakes.
The perfect example of how people react differently to different situations.
So there's many different areas of psychology. For instance, personality psychologists would look at what's going on here and try to really understand the individual differences and the fear and why I'm not really afraid, you're fine, and she's more or less terrified.
Behavioral psychologists might look at an individual's learning history. So for example, I was exposed to a lot of snakes when I was growing up, so perhaps I've learned that snakes aren't dangerous for me. And a social psychologist may look at how other people's behavior influences our own. So for example, looking at other people's reactions may influence our own reactions. A biological psychologist perhaps may look at Lauren's fright response in terms of increase in heart rate or even sweating. And a neuroscientist, they may look at the areas of the brain that are activated during the fear response, such as the amygdala. But for now, I think it's time for Tickles to head home.
Even though this example exploited my fear of snakes, thanks a lot, Greg. It was a really effective tool for Susan and Greg to use to show you just how diverse psychology can be. Now, psychology is defined as a study of thought and behavior, and it's an amazing way to make sense of our world.